In this video, we will explore how to use capacitor and ionic PWA elements to capture photos in your cross-platform app. We will discuss why these technologies are essential, walk through a basic implementation from a code perspective, and cover a key aspects of using the device camera. All of this will be demonstrated within the context of Angular application. In web development, we can use the native JavaScript Media Devices interface from the Media Capture and Streams API to access a device's camera and take pictures. However, when building a cross-platform progressive web app, it's much better to use Ionic PWA elements and capacitor for seamless access to native device features. We get these benefits. Cross-platform compatibility. Works seamlessly with Capacitor on iOS and Android, while providing a web-based fullback for PWAs. Simplified permissions handling. No need to manually manage Navigator media devices. Capacitor acts as a bridge between your web code and the mobile device, allowing you to build apps that feel native while still using web technologies. Ionic PWA elements provides web-based replacements for certain native functionalities. For example, without Ionic PWA elements, when using Capacitor's camera plugin in a browser, it might open the file picker instead of the actual camera. With Ionic PWA elements, it adds a native-style camera preview in the browser, making it behave more like a mobile app. To begin, we need to initialize PWA elements for the application. I accomplish this in the root app component by calling the define custom elements function. It's a function that registers web components, custom HTML elements provided by Ionic PWA elements. This is my service, which encapsulates the essential logic for capturing photos using device cameras. It is primarily built on the Capacitor API. The takePicture method evaluates the provided quality parameter and then calls the getPhoto function from the Capacitor camera plugin, passing both the quality and result type parameters. You don't need to explicitly request permission when using the getPhoto method. Capacitor handles it automatically for you. The quality parameter in Capacitor camera controls native capture quality with built-in compression optimized by the device. I use 90 for high-quality images, ensuring flexibility for further optimization with a smarter library before uploading to the server. The result type parameter determines the format in which the image data is returned, offering three possible values. The recommended option is Camera Result Type URI, which returns an image URI. This format uses low memory, as the image is stored in the sandbox file system, temporary storage on the browser. On native mobile devices, iOS and Android, the image is stored in the app's temporary directory or photo library. I suggest avoiding the other two types, as both keep images in RAM, which can negatively impact performance. The web pass property is expected when using camera result type URI, but it may be missing in certain cases. This can happen due to platform-specific limitations, permission issues, or unexpected plugin behavior. Checking for WebPass ensures the code handles such cases gracefully, preventing errors when accessing the image URL. Let's go to the part where I trigger the picture-taking process. I've attached a click listener to this image button in the HTML template, which calls a method in the component class. Inside this method, I dispatch actions, which are then handled in the state. This is where I explicitly call the device camera service we explored earlier. I'm using state management in my app and handle many tasks through actions, but your architecture might allow for a shorter workflow. Simply put, when the user taps this icon, we need to trigger this functionality. In this method, the device camera service uses Capacitor camera plugin under the hood to access the camera. When a picture is successfully taken, we get a link to it, which can be used immediately in the app. I achieve this by patching my task state. Let's see how Capacitor works in action. It provides access to the camera and gallery. All of this is contained within the PWA camera model instance element. This isn't a native HTML element or a custom one I created. It's dynamically injected by Ionic PWA elements, which we initialize by calling define custom elements. After taking a photo, it becomes immediately available to the application through a link that points to the image in temporary storage. For now, we store the picture in a temporary folder. At this point, we move it to the server's persistent storage by calling an API. I handle the upload logic in the uploader service. Let's take a closer look at this service. To upload an image to the server, we first need to convert the URI into a form data object that can be attached to a post request. We retrieve the blob object from the URI with the fetch function. It's best to reduce the image size to avoid sending unnecessary large files. With the MIME library, define the correct file extension. Create a unique name for the image by generating a random ID using the UUID function. Finally, we build a form data object using the blob to prepare it for upload. The last thing I want to discuss is the image optimizer service, which utilizes the smart compression library compressor.js. Setting it up is straightforward. You simply need to adjust the quality parameter, ranging from 0 to 1, and specify the image type. While the type is generally optional, I found that it didn't work for me without explicitly setting it. If you know why that might be the case, let me know in the comments. It's generally best to compress images before uploading them to the server. However, the optimal compression level depends on your specific business needs. I conducted some experiments by compressing the same image at different levels. Currently, I'm using 0.6, but based on this graph, it might be smarter to use 0.7 or 0.8, as the file size reduction beyond the 0.8 is minimal. You can find all the code from the video, along with detailed comments, in repository linked below. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share and subscribe if you haven't already. Your support motivates me to create more content about progressive web applications. Thank you.